In this section, we will cover the topic GCF, which is gingival crevicular fluid. The things which we will study about GCF are the definition of GCF, how GCF formation occurs, whether it is a transudate or an exudate, various composition of GCF and methods of collection of GCF. Now, let us first know what is GCF. Gingival crevicular fluid is the serum exudate that appears in the gingival sulcus and that contains molecular and cellular elements of the immune response. Now, how GCF formation occurs? GCF formation is based upon two theories. Formation of GCF is based on two theories. One proposed by Brill and Eagleburg, and the other proposed by Alfano and Pashley. Now, according to Brill and Eagleburg, GCF is a transudate. What is a transudate? A transudate is the leakage of the fluid from the capillaries. Because of the increase in the permeability of the capillaries, whatever fluid comes out is known as transudate. So, according to them, when there is inflammation, there is increase in the permeability, increase in permeability of capillaries, which leads to fluid transudate coming out of the capillaries. Fluid transudate coming out of the capillaries leading to GCF formation. So according to Brill and Eagleburg, GCF is a transudate. Later on, Alfano and Pashley proposed that Alfano said that initial fluid that is formed into the GCF is a transudate. Initial fluid that is formed because of the osmotic gradient, change in the osmotic gradient of the blood capillaries lead to formation of transudate. But as the inflammation in the fluid increases, it leads to the formation of exudate. So what happens according to Pashley proposed a model which is according to which this how the circulation occurs is initially the fluid comes to capillaries, from capillaries it goes to tissues, and from tissues it is drained by the lymphatic system. Now, during inflammation, what happens is the number of capillaries increases, also the amount of molecules and the cells which are coming to the inflammatory sites also increases. So, the number of molecular, and because of the increase in the molecular and cellular content of the capillaries, what happens is the amount of filtrate that is coming out of the capillaries also increases. So there is increase in capillary filtrate. And this filtrate that is coming out cannot be drained at an equal level by the lymphatic system. So, if the lymphatic system is not taking up the fluid, what will happen? This will lead to either tissue edema, or the fluid will come out through some way. And in the mouth, it comes out through the junctional epithelium, which is known as GCF. And it will come out in the form of GCF in the sulcus. So, this is the model that is proposed by Pashley, and thus we can say that initial fluid which is produced into the GCF is the transudate, and later on what is formed is the exudate. Let us know what is the difference between an exudate and a transudate. Transudate and an exudate. A transudate is a fluid content that comes out of the capillaries, a fluid substance that comes out of capillaries because of increased permeability of capillaries. And an exudate is formed because of increase in the inflammation leads to gap in epithelial cells of the capillary, and this leads to increase in fluid and other components which come out of the capillaries leads to the formation of exudate. Thus, we can say that GCF is an inflammatory exudate, because some level of inflammation is always going on at the level of gingival sulcus. Also, the protein content of exudate is more. Protein content of exudate is more than the transudate. It is transudate is a clear substance while it is cloudy. Exudate is cloudy, and the specific gravity also of exudate is more than the transudate. These are some of the differences between a transudate and an exudate. Now let us see some of the points regarding exudate and transudate. Actually, GCF is both exudative fluid and transudative fluid. Initially it is exudate and later on it is transudate. Thus you know that majorly GCF is a transudate. It is an inflammatory transudate. Sorry, majorly it is an inflammatory exudate, not transudate. Primarily the fluid that is coming out is a transudate, and later on the fluid that is coming out is the exudate. So primarily GCF is a transudate, inflammatory exudate. Primarily GCF. Now Verhong and Brill and Cross elucidated its role in the oral defense mechanism. Verhong, Brill and Crossy said that there are various antibodies present into the GCF. The antibody which is present in GCF is IgG, which is responsible for the defense of the GCF. So this was said by Verhong, Brill and Cross. Alfano called it as inflammatory exudate. This we have already seen. And Brill proposed it as a transudate. So these are the points which you must remember for MCQs, for answering important MCQs. An extensive research has been done on the composition of GCF, because GCF contains various components which act as prognostic and diagnostic marker for the progression of periodontal disease, Thus, an extensive research has been carried out on the composition of GCF. Now, let us see what is the composition of GCF in an overview in this flowchart. GCF consists of enzymes, cellular elements, organic content, and electrolytes. The electrolytes which are present into the GCF are sodium, potassium, calcium. Enzymes which are present into the GCF are beta glucuronidase, lactic acid dehydrogenase, collagenase, and phospholipase. Apart from this, alkaline phosphatase, acid phosphatase, pyrophosphatase are also present. As you can see, what happens during inflammation is the degradation of collagen. So definitely the amount of collagenase will increase. So this shows, if we measure the enzymes in the GCF and if we found the level of collagenase is more, this shows that an active periodontal disease is going on because of degradation of collagen is more. Similarly, if increased level of alkaline phosphatase, acid phosphatase and pyrophosphatase is seen in the GCF sample, we can make out that there is active bone resorption going on, because these enzymes are responsible for bone resorption. And if the sample is low or they are not found into the GCF, then we can conclude that the disease, periodontal disease, has stopped. Thus, in this way, enzymes act as very important markers of periodontal disease. Similarly, the other contents which can be found are cellular elements which are more commonly found are PMNS. PMNS are mostly found into the initial disease when the inflammation just started. So these are the primary line defense cells. So they will be found during the initial stages of the disease. Bacterias also during the active periodontal disease is going on. Desquamated epithelial cells mostly may be found at the later stages of the disease when the disease is subsiding. At that time we can find desquamated epithelial cells. Mononuclear cells, B lymphocytes, T lymphocytes, mononuclear phagocytosis, these are also found at the later stages of periodontal disease. Thus, from these elements we can know what is the progression of the disease, whether the periodontal disease is in active condition, whether it has subsided. All these things we can know from the composition of GCF. The fourth content is the organic component. The organic components included in the GCF are carbohydrates, glucose hexazamine, hyaluronic acid, protein, and metabolic products from the bacteria. What are the metabolic products from the bacteria? Metabolic products from the bacteria includes urea, hydroxyproline, lactic acid, formic acid, ammonia. All these are released by the bacteria. Metabolism of the bacterial products. Thus, we can say that an active bacterial disease is going on into the gingival sulcus. Thus, this is the composition of GCF, and brief idea is given about how these enzymes and how these cellular GCF components help us in diagnosing the periodontal disease, progression of periodontal disease, and what will be the prognosis of the periodontal disease. All these we can determine from the composition of GCF. Let us discuss some of the important meritus prep facts. The first point is these points are very important from for MCQ point of view, and various MCQs are asked from these points. So just remember them nicely. The first point is the ratio of T lymphocytes to B lymphocytes that is found into the blood smear is 3:1. Means in blood, in peripheral blood, the amount of T lymphocytes is more than the B lymphocytes. However, this ratio is reverse in GCF. It is 1:3. Thus, the level of T lymphocytes is lesser in GCF than B lymphocytes. Next point is, gingival sulcus is the main port of entry for into the oral cavity. So, the bacteria from the oral cavity enter into the connective tissue through the gingival sulcus, and various whatever medicines and whatever enzymes that are produced into the GCF and medicines which we take, and the higher glucose content is also seen into the GCF. How it enters? It enters in from the gingival when they enter into the oral cavity, they enter through the gingival sulcus. Thus, we can say that gingival sulcus is the main port of entry into the oral cavity for various components of the body, of the blood and the serum. Now, protein content. The protein content of gingival fluid is much less than the serum, and the glucose content of the GCF is 3-4 times greater than the blood, than the serum. Thus, we can say that glucose content of GCF is 3-4 times greater than serum. These are the important points which you must remember for MCQ. Let us discuss the clinical significance of gingival crevicular fluid. GCF shows a circadian rhythm. Circadian rhythm means it increases at a certain specific period of time of the day. So GCF increases from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. and after that it starts decreasing. Also, the second point is female sex hormones are increased in GCF. Female sex hormones increase in GCF like progesterone and estrogen. Now, these progesterone hormones increase during pregnancy and puberty. Similarly, estrogen, higher content of progesterone is seen during pregnancy. The amount of GCF increases during inflammation. Why it increases during inflammation? Definitely, as we all know, during inflammation what happens is there is increase in the blood circulation to the inflamed site. So, the GCF amount increases. GCF is not increased by TFO, but it is increased by mastication of coarse food. Mastication of fibrous foods like any salads or green leafy vegetables which we are eating, it leads to irritation of the gingiva and thus ultimately leads to increase in the secretion of GCF. Chewing and vigorous gingival brushing stimulates the oozing of gingival crevicular fluid from the gingival sulcus. This is also because of the irritation of the gingiva. Smoking leads to transient increase in GCF, and healing period. During healing period also it is noted that gingival crevicular fluid increases. This we all know that during healing what occurs is the formation of granulation tissue, and during formation of granulation tissue the blood supply to that area increases, and thus there is increase in the capillaries and increase in the GCF fluid. Tetracycline is the drug which shows the highest concentration, maximum concentration into the GCF. Now let us see the functions of GCF. GCF cleans materials from the sulcus. So, whatever waste products that are formed into the body, such as urea, and the waste products that are formed by the bacteria are released into the oral cavity with the help of GCF. GCF contains plasma proteins that improves the adhesion of epithelium to the tooth. It possesses antimicrobial properties. How it possesses antimicrobial properties? Because it possesses various immunoglobulins. The dominant immunoglobulin is IgG. Also, it possesses lysozyme, which is responsible for the defense mechanism. So, we can say that GCF possesses antimicrobial activity. It exerts antibody activity in the defense of the gingiva, and this antibody which is most prevalent in the GCF is IgG. So, let us discuss few questions of this section. The first question is, gingival fluid is a, as we have already studied, what is gingival fluid? Gingival fluid is an inflammatory exudate. Only small amount of gingival fluid has a transudate plot, but mostly it is inflammatory exudate as proposed by Pashley and Alfano. Alfano and Pashley. Thus, we can say that gingival fluid is an exudate. The answer to this question is an inflammatory exudate. Let us discuss the next question. The next question is, glucose level in the GCF are, as we have already studied in the facts prepared by the Meritus, that Meritus prep facts, that glucose, let us see the options first. Glucose level in the GCF are equal to the glucose level in the serum? No, this is not the answer. It is zero in the GCF? No, definitely not. The third option is, it is 3 to 4 times greater than serum. Yes, this is the answer to this question. Glucose levels in GCF are 3 to 4 times greater than that of the serum. So, the answer to this question is option number 3.